Hello. Thank you so much for joining me today. I know it's the last session of the day, so thank you, really. Thank you so much. This is Comic Character Connections, and basically it's going to be talking about diversity in comic books and manga. Okay, so actually before I begin, let me just I wanted to actually just go over some terms because actually after going to an HLA, the next step session about graphic novels, I learned that perhaps maybe not as many people know about what a graphic novel is as I thought people would know. I just have some of these things, you know, the graphic novels, what's manga versus anime. And also, by the way, if you haven't been to a Next Step session, you really should go to one because they're very interesting and they're like an hour long and it's really great. Go to the HLA website and yeah. But reading these terms, does anybody have any questions about these terms? Because basically, you know, a graphic novel is it's a full-length comic book. You know, manga is the Japanese and other Asian ones. And I know other Asian countries, they do have their name for their manga, but usually it's all shoved under manga. So I just left manga. And then the difference between manga and anime is that manga is books and anime is cartoons. So, you know, you would watch it like a TV show, a film, video. Yeah. So any questions about that? Okay. So next was okay, and here's where I'm supposed to be talking about, you know, how good diversity is and inclusion and all that kind of stuff. But you know, sorry, I know a lot of you guys know me, but you know, diversity, obviously inclusion, yes, we should have it. It is a good thing. And I kind of do feel that, you know, libraries, if they can make a difference in lowering, you know, the amount of intolerance, and that's a good thing. And also using graphic novels does seem to make it easier to bring up subjects that, you know, people may find different or intimidating, you know, things like that. So first, I want to just show, and this is actually an older clip from Static Shock, which yeah, is a cartoon. So.
Richie, I brought over the latest MC Rapwell CD. It is slamming.
Yeah, we'll crank it after dinner.
There will be no rap played in this house.
Sean, please.
Maggie, that music teaches kids to disrespect their parents.
Some rap is positive, Mr. Foley.
It's all garbage. It tells kids to write on walls, stay out past curfews, and heaven knows what else. It tears down everything guys like me built. Look around you, Dakota's gone to pot. Well, not in my house.
But Dad, that's not fair.
That's the last word, Richie.
My dad, sometimes, you know, I'm so embarrassed.
Will you stop? My pops hates hip-hop too. It's not a black-white thing, it's an old thing. As far as I'm concerned, this whole thing is squashed. Time to get minty fresh. Down the hall, right?
Yeah.
And now I see why Richie acts like a hood, Maggie. That kid's a bad influence. All his kind are.
Keep your voice down.
It's bad enough I gotta deal with them all day long. Now one of them's in my house.
It's still early. I can go home without calling my pops for a ride.
Virgil, don't leave, please. We can talk to my mom.
What good is that gonna do, Rich? She can't change what he said. You were right all along. Hanging here was a bad idea. Sorry.
What's going on down there?
Well, you got what you wanted, Dad. My best friend's gone because of you and your stupid racism. I hate you!
Hey!
So, yeah, that was actually a clip from, I think it was like 2000 or 2001. So, as you can tell, it's very, you know, very blunt, and it, you know, the audience was a Saturday morning cartoon audience. But the graphic novels now, and even, you know, the later Static Shock comics, you know, they were a lot more nuanced, a lot not so blatantly, you know, this is racism kind of thing. These are some of the titles that, and I'm just kind of showing things that if you were going to have a class or a discussion or some sort of book talk thing, these were ones that I sort of chose. And some I know you'll recognize, they're very classic. They're older ones. The newest one I would say is this one, This Family Style, by Tian Pham. And it's the newest one, and it's a really interesting, and it's a one shot. So yeah, it's only one book. It's not a series. And it's nice because it does show his emigration to America, and he's on the mainland, and now he's in California. But it is a really nice, you know, compilation of what he goes through. Because for him, his memories mostly center around food, you know, the food, like, you know, when he was, you know, getting ready to move, what he ate on the boat over, what, you know, the things that he remembers. So it was a really, really nice story. Oh, by the way, sorry, I don't know if there are any questions or everyone is muted. So I'm not really sure if anyone like has any questions or feedback or things like that.
I can read things from the chat if you'd like, Hillary.
Oh, okay.
Sure.
I mean, because is it about this or just other general
They were
questions
just
or
some
wait?
general
Oh.
thoughts. So I can, if something comes up, I'll let you know.
Oh, okay. Okay. Thank you. Okay. So, yeah, I don't know if, okay. So the next one, sort of like trying to, is it not going? You know, kind of keeping with the whole. Okay. Why are we not? Okay, here we go. So another topic, you know, for diversity's sake is the LGBTQ plus genre, which has really skyrocketed. And that's a good thing because now that they have so many different types of publishers and not just the manga. I mean, it started off with the manga, and now the US is noticing, hey, there's a market for it. So it's a lot more popular with US titles too. For how should I say this? For me, a lot of the boys love ones are very truly like romance types of things. It's very sweet. It's very Hallmark. But I mean, and so, you know, reality, you know, it's like any other romance, but I must say I kind of like that better than what they had before, where a lot of the yaoi boys love stories were, I thought, quite predatory, where, you know, one person was so experienced and the other person was just questioning their sexuality, and it's like, here, let me force myself on you, and after we have sex, you'll see that you really like it and that you're gay. I mean, that really was how a lot of titles were before, and I thought it was, you know, well, personally, it made me very uncomfortable. But you know, I'm thinking, gosh, you know, I was an adult when these things were coming out, and I'm thinking, gosh, what if you were a teen? This is not really how you should find out, you know, your sexuality. But now it kind of, in my opinion, it's almost swerved the opposite, where it is very sweet, very touching. If I would say, like, if you were going to do some sort of book talk or something, this one is really, really nice. It's one of the newer ones, The Princess and the Grilled Cheese Sandwich, which is very cute, where it's about this woman and she dresses as a man so that she can take over her father's estate. And then she meets the princess, and you know, they kind of fall in love. And but the princess does think, you know, she's a man, and It's yeah, it's the one shot. So yeah, it is very, very nice. Another nice one too is this Bingo Love. And I kind of like it too because it's two African American women who, when they meet and they're attracted to each other, they fall in love. But then, one kind of wonders, can I live this life? Can I be a lesbian just because it takes, it's sort of like them looking back. It's, I mean, they're older now. And so, most of their story takes place in the past where a lot of, LGBTQ plus things are just not accepted. Heartstopper, you probably all know about this one because of the TV show, which is a really, really well done. The TV show is really well done. The only thing, and probably this is not going to be an issue for you, but for me, Heartstopper is that the art to me is just too basic, and I can't sort of get over that. So, but the TV show is really, it's really, really good. I'm going to show you a clip, and it's going to be from this Sasaki and Miyano, and basically it's about two high school boys, who met, and now they're starting to date, and you'll kind of see the whole sweetness that I'm talking about. But before I play it, does anybody not know about Valentine's Day in Japan? Because I'll. Okay. So basically, in Japan, Valentine's Day is a day where the girls give boys the presents. And usually it's like chocolate or some kind of sweets or something like that. And if you kind of like want to show your emotion, the more you do it, it's like, you'll make something yourself. So a lot of times there'll be classes, how to make your own chocolate so that you can give it to, the person you're kind of interested in. And then a month later, the boys are supposed to reciprocate and give, chocolates and sweets back to the girls. So that's sort of the setup of what the clip is going to be talking about with Valentine's Day.
去年は待たせた分じゃないけど、俺にできること、いっぱいしたい。一緒にバレンタインチョコを作る。俺も先輩に作りたいって思ったんですけど、その、ちょっと料理うまくできなくて。その、どうでしょうか、先輩。
やっぱり。ああ、大丈夫。お母さん、シュウがまだなんか作ろうとしてる。チョコとか売ってる。ごめん、ちょっと待ってて。チクんなよ。あんた試験終わったからってお菓子作りすぎ。太るじゃん。食わなきゃいいじゃん。みやちゃん、笑ったでしょ。いえ、そんなことは。また後で連絡します。あ。母さん。
バレンタインの日さ、人とチョコ作ってもいい？そのうちで。ホットケーキを5回連続で失敗して、もう料理しないって言ったあのよしくんが？
声が大きいよ。
いいけど、学校の子？うん、先輩。男の子どうして準備するのね。最近は男の子から揚げたりするものね。いいな。 今度ママにも作って。
あげたい人、男の人なんだ。
そうなの。今度ママにも紹介してね。
あのさ、その先輩と一緒にいるの楽しくて、これからも一緒にいたいって思って。好きで。
うん、いいね。好きなの。ママもパパのこと好き。もしかして一緒に作る人？夕飯食べていってもらったら？
え？
好き嫌いとかは？
聞いてみる。母さんが親でよかった。
なに？ママ泣いちゃう。
泣かないでよ。
よかった。お邪魔しました。
送ってくる。
はーい、また来てね。
先輩、あの、合格発表の日っていつでした？
ん？
ああ、いえ。今日はありがとうございました。
おう。はい、みゃーちゃんの分。
え？
みゃーちゃんのお母さんに教えてもらって、ラッピングしてみた。
え？俺、何も持ってない。食べた時ので交換って思って。ちょっと待っててください。
うん。
これをこう。俺からの分です。なんで気づかなかった？というか、いつの間に母と。
ありがとう。トイレ行ってた間にね。
来年は一人で先輩に渡せるもの作れるようになります。
来年も、うん、じゃあ俺はミャーちゃんの隣でミャーちゃんに渡すチョコを作ろうかな。
先輩の手を煩わせないように練習しておきます。
ここまででいいよ。
はい、
じゃあね、おやすみ。
おやすみなさい。
Yeah, see, so as you can tell, it's really, you know, very sweet, very nice. I don't know if you guys, okay, see, because this is sort of like my theory of why, you know, boys' love actually has gotten so popular. And it's actually because, to me, and I'm sorry, I don't really mean to insult anybody, but honestly, you know, men can be stupid where women cannot. Okay, and I'm just sorry, you know, okay. And so right when it's two men and men are going, oh, I don't know, am I, oh, you know, and, you know, they're thinking about their sexuality and things like that. And I'm sorry, but women, I really do feel, are not allowed to be, yeah, that dumb. I hate to say it, but, you know, and you know, how a man is kind of allowed to be kind of pathetic, whereas a woman, after a while, you'd sort of kind of like lose respect for her. But anyway, that's sort of like my theory of why, you know, to me, yeah, the boys' love thing has just taken off. And but, you know, it is fun, and it's, you know, it's nice. And like I said, it, you know, it's very, very sweet. And so I guess if, yeah, you're not as much into the Hallmark stuff like me, you know, you might be going, oh, God, this is just too unrealistic, which, you know, yeah, it sort of, certain parts, yeah, very much is. Okay. So the next thing is sort of like, I sort of just put down the ADA things, because these are more sort of, you know, actual disabilities, handicaps, things like that. We have the El Defo, you know, Comey can't communicate. This ripple effects, I thought it was kind of interesting. It's an adult title, and it's more, well, it's about this man who's a hero, but then he also suffers from diabetes. So certain things where his, you know, he has his invulnerabilities, and then yet this, you know, disease can really affect him. With the Light has been around forever, you know, about the woman who has an autistic child. Finding Gossamer is also about an autistic boy who, him and his sister are transported to this fantasy world where he's actually, you know, he's autistic, but then he also is very good with calculations and formulas. And in this world, that is, you know, that's actually what gives you power. So when he goes to this new world, he finds himself very, very powerful. This perfect world is about these two sort of like childhood friends to kind of connect back with each other when they're new adults. And the thing is, he now is in a wheelchair. And then last one, A Sign of Affection, is about a deaf character. And sometimes I have to say that, you know, so sort of like a response in America is different to a response of a disability in Japan. And I'm not saying they're more, you know, intolerant, but I do in a way feel that in Japan, they're a lot, not less educated, but you don't think, oh, you know, like, especially like, you know, with the light where, you know, her son sometimes has tantrums. And even the people who know he's autistic still think, oh no, it's because, you know, you're a bad mom. That's why your son is acting out, you know, kind of thing. And you're allowing this to happen. So that is something that, depending, you know, which titles you do get, sometimes, yeah, with the Japanese titles, you kind of have to, not exactly with a grain of salt, but it is different. It is going to be a different story as to somebody, you know, like an autistic person in the U.S. But I also wanted to sort of say that, you know, with the whole, you know, what I call the, you know, the ADA diversity titles, most of you people probably already have an ADA title in your collection, and it's Daredevil. And it's just because Daredevil, if you don't know, he's a blind person. But long story short, the way he got blind also heightened up all of his other senses. So in a way, he doesn't need a sight anymore, because, you know, all the other senses are so heightened that he actually can function quite well and be a superhero. And actually this Guardian Devil, if this is actually another really good sharing one, if you need to do a discussion or something like that. This is actually the title that I use with a lot of parents who've, you know, way long time ago were like, oh my God, I don't want my kid, you know, reading comics and da, da, da. And I would give them this one, and they came back going, oh yeah, the story is really, really good. Well, I don't know, long story short, this story, if you don't know, but Matt Murdock, he, you know, he's Daredevil, he's a superhero, but he's also what I like to call a recovering Catholic. And so in this book, things happen that also challenge his Catholic beliefs, you know. Anyway, that's that one. So I just want to show you a couple of clips. The first one is going to be from El Defo. El Defo is autobiographical, you know, Cece Bell, and it's her, you know, she gets sick and then basically loses her hearing. And so this is sort of like a clip of sort of like a neighborhood friend that she ends up making.
Watch you cross the street. You're in fourth grade, right? I'm in third, and my mom doesn't do that.
That's just my mom for you.
Well, anyway, I'm making dirt soup. Want to help?
Sure.
We've got to add just the right amount of water.
Yeah, too much egg gets a wackadoodle.
Yeah, a wackadoodle. Hey, what are those things?
Huh?
Those prickly things with the nuts inside, you know.
Oh, you mean buckeyes?
Yeah, buckeyes. Let's get some of those for our soup. Dirt soup, dirt soup. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
As far as I could tell, Martha didn't know a single thing about my hearing aid, and I wanted to keep it that way. I just wanted her to like me for me.
Hey, I got a great idea. Want to spend the night tonight?
Yes!
Woo! split one?
Yeah, thanks.
We're gonna get takeout and eat in front of the TV.
A TV supper? Really?
What you wanna get? Do you wanna...
How about you're having?
Okay, two fish sandwiches.
Fish? Oh.
Yuck! I hated fish.
Yum.
But it was worth it. I had to make sure Martha didn't think there was anything different about me.
Yum! Blech.
How about tomorrow we walk downtown and get drinks and candy bars and stuff, and then we can make candy soup.
That sounds cool.
Have you ever noticed that weird smell near the school? It's like old bologna and sweaty feet. One whiff of pee, you see. You didn't hear my mom. She said, what's that awful stinky smell? Talk about I said, did you just turn your hearing aids off on me?
Hearing aids?
Yeah, it's hilarious that you just turned me off like that. I wish I could do that with her.
Wait, what? How did you know that I can't hear very good?
Oh, the other kids told me.
So, you've known all along?
Sure.
Hmm.
Yeah. Were you worried about that? I'm gonna be your friend no matter what. What? Let's pinky swear it.
Yeah!
Night, night, Cece.
Night, Martha.
Hi. I'm Marvy Girl.
Yes? May I help you?
I'm here about the ad. Sidekick wanted.
Oh, yes. I see. What are your qualifications, Marmy Girl?
Well, I have total recall of most everything on TV. I'm loyal, brave, and true. And I can make you laugh until you pee your pants.
Well, that does it. You're hired.
Awesome! Whee!
This universe is brighter with you in it, Marvy Girl. Together, we're unstoppable. By the power of the pinky, do you swear to fight against boredom and loneliness and to never swerve from the path of true friendship?
I swear it.
Okay, yeah. See, so this one I really like because, as you can tell, it's from Cece's point of view. And so, you know, the audio sometimes goes off or like, right, it's how she hears it differences, you know, and that I really did like. The next clip is from Komi Can't Communicate. And basically, this is about a girl. And the reason why is that she's drop dead gorgeous. And so a lot of people don't want to approach her anyway, but she actually has anxiety communicating. So she doesn't actually talk to people and she's never really had a conversation. You know, she doesn't say hello. She doesn't, you know, really, you know, how was your day? Anything like that. And so basically this is just a clip of sort of a classmate of hers. And it's basically like her first conversation at school. Okay, yeah, so that was just like my other clip. Yeah. Okay. Lastly, I just also wanted to mention these are not really diversity in the sense of the traditional sense, but these are just some other topics that I don't know, maybe unfortunately that we do have to deal with now. The top three are, yeah, true tragic things. You know, Fire Story is about the wildfires in Northern California, a few years back, and then this the Paramoha is about the war in Ukraine, and the Where We Live is about the Las Vegas mass shooting. And these are actually two benefit books, and Hey Kiddo has been around. There's a sequel to it also, and that's basically about child neglect and child abuse. And, you know, well, this is a pretty obvious menopause, and maybe this isn't a tragedy, except if you're going through it. You know, so, but that's basically that. And this is my last slide. And of course, if anybody has any questions, I think we can all maybe unmute ourselves and get to. Oh, wait, let me just stop sharing. Okay. Sorry, I don't know if you wanted. Sorry, did everybody get the information? Sorry, of my email. It is on that sheet that I uploaded. Because it's just Hillary. Yeah, it's just hillary.chang@librarieshawaii.org.
Yeah, I was going to tell people to make sure they check
Oh,
the session thing because
okay.
you uploaded your book list there and
Okay,
your
yeah.
contact information. So, yeah. I just, there weren't questions so much as
Okay.
comments. There was some interesting things. I think people were surprised about the Japanese Valentine's Day. I had never heard that either,
Oh.
which is really interesting. And then there was a comment, most teachers try to keep kids away from graphic novels because of the pictures. Students enjoy reading them though. Yeah. If you, I don't know if you want to, it feel like we've talked about this a million times in our profession, but if you have any thoughts on that.
Well, actually, like a lot of other genres, and I'm sorry, I call it a genre, I don't call it a format. You know, there are going to be prejudices against that. And I know I do remember a parent telling me how, you know, she thought it was, I guess, like a lesser, form of literature. And I just said, well, you know, and actually, you know, growing up in a way, I felt that way too. I mean, I thought it was just for entertainment, but like all, you know, I mean, almost everything, it does evolve. And so now there are so much more, how should I say it, you know, good works, you know, and entertaining and educational, you know, at the same time. And, you know, I kind of equate it to kind of like TV where, you know, there's a lot of TV shows where, yeah, you just go and it's fun. And there's other things that, right, it's for learning. And that's sort of like how graphic novels are too. For me, with graphic novels is that it is sort of, I mean, I don't want to call it a gateway, you know, thing, but it is You know, because I know a lot of people who have started with graphic novels, then they
Mm-hmm.
go off because actually, especially now, there's a lot of authors of regular books, you know, that have made graphic novels. So they start off with a graphic novel and then they read all of the other, you know, the author's regular works and then they find other authors.
Yeah, that's a great point.
Sorry.
Yes.
I just want to say that we have a lot of graphic novels. And in fact, as for our banned books week, we had a lot of LGBTQ plus graphic novels. And we are doing a banned book reading and discussion on, oh, shoot, Magic Fish.
Okay.
For our students and faculty. So
Oh,
that's this
excellent.
month.
Excellent.
And we have a lot of English ESL students
Okay.
because they
Yes, nice.
have face-to-face classes, even though like the majority of our classes are online, but they love having the graphic novels and the ESL, you know, teachers, they feel like, you know, like us, hey, we don't care what you're reading. We just want you to read, right? So,
Yes,
anyway,
yes.
thank you for
Oh,
this, Hillary. You
excellent.
always
Oh,
do
no,
such a
thank you so
wonderful job.
much. Thank you.
I miss
Yes.
eating popcorn watching.
Yes.
So let's do
Oh,
that hopefully next
yes,
year.
yes. Oh, and also, I went to Cannes this year, and I'm really going to try to get, you know, Kazuki Buishi, who did the Amulet series? It's ending. Amulet is ending next February, I think. And so he's going to have a book tour on the mainland. And so hopefully I can get him down here after that. Yeah. I don't know if you guys know, that's another really, I mean, it's not, you know, not really diversity, but yeah, if you guys just want a good series to read, Amulet, yeah, by Kazu Kibuishi is another one. Yeah. And it's just nine books, so it's pretty good.
Okay, we're at time. I was just going to tell you a lot of the things in the chat for just saying what a great job you did.
Oh, thank you.
So, yeah,
Thank
thank you
you.
everyone for being here and thank you so much, Hillary. The recording will be posted and trying to think what else I'm supposed to say at the end of this. Please fill out the evaluation
Oh, yes.
and we will see you all soon. Hopefully, we'll see you tomorrow and thank you so much.